And a happy Christmas to you all. Can I first of all begin with a word of thanks? I want to thank all those who sent cards, gifts, and words of encouragement, even at this stage, to the manse. It is good to be part of the Glendermot family, and it's good for us to come out and to worship on a day like today. I suppose we should really on a day like today. You'll get a wee chance later on, but you'll know over this past while we've been encouraging folk to say hello to each other, to get to know each other a little bit better. So take a couple of moments now and just stand up, turn around and wish the person behind you a happy Christmas. It's really great to see you all here. It's really great to see us having to put out extra chairs and so on. It's a great problem to have. And of course, we welcome all here this morning, whether you're here. Well, I'll do my wee saying. If you're here for the first time, the odd time, or every time, it's really good to have you with us here. I'm going to spend a wee bit of during the service to have a wee look around to see who's got the best Christmas outfit or not on. But I think I know who's getting the prize. Oh, here, I forgot about it. But we get the full works. What's the saying? If you're going to do it right. Isn't that what they say? Listen, it is a joyful occasion. It's good. We should be filled with joy every time we come to worship, of course. But of course, we come on a very special day today to worship together at the day that marks the day of our Savior's birth. And what a wonderful thing that is for us to do. We're here to worship and to celebrate that day. So we're going to begin with our first piece of praise together. Come and join the celebration. The words should come up on your screen. So let's all stand and let's worship God together.
Thank you.
going to have to apologize for my lack of singing. There's the odd wee word coming to me there, but I forgot to print myself out some words, so I can't see the TV screens, but it's great to hear the singing coming from the congregation. Let's just take a moment. Let's come to God in prayer. Let's commit our time to Him. Let's pray. Father, we come as always thankful for each and every opportunity that you give us to come and to worship you. Father, we thank you that we come on this extra special day as we come to celebrate the birth of our Savior Jesus. And Father, we come so thankful that that event did indeed happen, that Jesus came to this earth as that little baby. But, well, as we've been reminded about over the past number of weeks, that, well, this was only the beginning of the story. Father, we thank you that Jesus was born into this world to save us from our sins. We thank you for his life, his death, and his glorious resurrection. Lord, what a wonderful thing to celebrate today. Father, we thank you for the opportunity to gather as your family, to enjoy the fellowship that we have together. And Father, as we meet here today as your people, we pray that you would indeed bless us as we seek to celebrate and to bless your name together. So will you lead us in this time of worship, Lord? Will you help us to focus on you and you alone in this time that we've set aside? Lord, we know, especially on days like today as we come, it is so easy to get distracted by the celebrations that are yet to come today. But Father, in this time, Lord, just still our hearts that we might focus on you and on Jesus, our Savior, in whose name we pray. Amen. Amen. I'm hoping you'll know on last Sunday morning, we had a little technical hitch with our video. We didn't get to see the video that the youth club had made for us, so we're going to try it again today. If it doesn't work, go on to Facebook. If you have that availability, and you will get it there. But hopefully, I will get a flavour. It's a little message from the folk at the youth club. Give it a go, David.
Tech 77, action.
Yeah, just keep going. You're with your
Tech 78, action.
What's your favourite part about Christmas?
Being up school.
Christmas dinner!
Santa!
What's your favourite part about Christmas?
Friends and family.
At Youth Club, we've been learning about the true meaning of Christmas.
Mince pies, chocolates and turkey are great, but as Christians we have more to celebrate.
A time for family and friends reunited, listening to stories that Santa has been cited.
Be joyful this Christmas, we have a good reason, a Savior was born for you this Christmas season.
Born in a stable, he turned the world upside down. The good news was spread to every village and town.
He came here to save us, and that's why we sing, Hosanna, glory to the newborn King.
Happy Christmas!
I'm under what? Oh, a lot of pressure now.
Take 77, action.
Yeah, just keep going. You're with your
Take 78.
Thank you to the folk at the youth club. I know any night I'm down, they really enjoy themselves, but it's good that there is that focus, of course, on Jesus as well. We're going to turn to God's Word for a moment here now. I want to read this morning it is the story of the birth of Jesus from Matthew's Gospel, chapter 1, a reading from verse 18 through to the end of the chapter. It's entitled in my Bible here, Joseph Accepts Jesus as His Son. This is God's Word. Let's hear it together. This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary was pleased to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, And you're to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he did not consummate their marriage until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus. Amen. We thank God for his word to us. If you remember last Sunday as well, the Sunday school sang a song for us, a little, maybe we could call it a little jazzier version of Away in a Manger. So we thought this morning we could all give it a go. But do the young folk want to come up to the front and we'll lead the congregation in it? Want all you ones who knew it? There might even be a wee treat for you when you get up here. You never know. Want to head on up? We're going to sing it. It's Away in a Manger, and there's a little twist to it for those who remember it, and hopefully our young people will give it a bit more jazz here. Everybody get an instrument? Everybody that wants one got one? Are you ready? Let's all stand and let's sing this together. Is it going to come on?
I know the reason, the Savior is born.
I thought we had practiced doing trombones and all sorts of things, trumpets and stuff. Listen, I know George is normally, stay where you're at a minute. I know you are going to get lots of sweeties and stuff later on today, aren't you? You probably have a pile of chocolate and you're ready. Who's ate chocolate already today? One or two? You're allowed chocolate for breakfast on Christmas Day, aren't you? No, but you ate it anyway. I've got a little bag with lots of different sweets in it. And anybody that's not up the front, I'll take the bag to the door as well. But where'd Valerie go? Here. Save me leaning down there in case I burst my suit when I bend down. That would never do now, would it? And you see, if I was to say to you now, you can open your sweets up and eat them, how long do you think they would last? They wouldn't last very long, sure they wouldn't. But that's one of the wonderful things about Christmas. These things don't last. But we know a God, we know a Savior. He lasts forever. Anybody that said didn't get, Valerie will take them to the door with us. I normally like to allow you a few moments. I know we all welcomed each other, but that was kind of just where you were at. So it's my kind of practice. I don't know the normal practice here, but we're just going to take 5 minutes before we come and think about God's Word for a minute to have a wander about and have a chat to each other. And those who you haven't already seen and spoken to, wish them a happy Christmas. And I'll give you a wee shout in 5 minutes. But relax, folk. Relax. It's good to take time to get to know each other. It's good to take time to wish each other a happy Christmas and so on. So listen, go for it. I think everybody's nearly back in their seats now again. This is the hard bit now. Do you ever hear that saying, "Howl your wheest"? I know it's good to take that time. It is. It's good to spend that time together. It's good for me to be able to wander around and see some of the toys as well, because I'm kind of out of touch with all that. But there's everything from pump action, Nerf guns and everything there. So it's good for me to get to play with the toys as well. But I'll see you all on the way. If I didn't catch you there now, I'll see you all on the way out anyway. We're going to continue worshipping God now as the offering is taken up. And you'll know today, we gave out on Sunday, we gave out the World Development Appeal envelope, so I trust many will have brought those back today. So let's worship God through our offering. Thank you. Let's just pray together for a moment. Let's pray. Father, we thank you, as always, for the wonderful opportunity that we have to come and to worship you through our offering. And Father, we thank you for this opportunity today to give, especially towards the work of the World Development Appeal. Lord, we thank you for the work of that appeal. Father, we thank you for the work of our church across this world. Lord, we pray that you would use this offering for the benefit of those less fortunate than ourselves. And Lord, that you would bless them through it. Indeed, bless us as we give towards that work. So Father, bless this offering and use it for your glory and that of your Son and our Savior, Jesus. We pray in his name. Amen. There's a woman out shopping one day, and as she's walking down the aisles in the shop, she sees this father wheeling the trolley along with, let's say, a typical two-year-old in the seat of the trolley, who's creating a bit of a fuss and so on. And as he's walking along, she hears him whispering, "Be patient, Billy. Be patient. You can handle this. It's okay. Calm down, Billy." She just can't help herself, and she walks over to the man. She's like, "I don't mean to interrupt your shopping or anything like that, but I just wanted to tell you how wonderful it is to see somebody being so loving and patient with little Billy." And the man turns back and says, "Actually, my son's name is Patrick. My name's Billy." There's that old saying that patience is a virtue, and I'm sure I've probably said to one or two before, I might even have mentioned it here, that it's probably not a strength of mine, it's probably not a strength of a lot of people. Patience is something we all struggle with. We all feel the same sometimes, as the pace of life around us seems to be getting faster and faster, and we all want to seem to get things in a hurry, and we want to be in a hurry to do things and so on. And the world, yeah, it kind of just has gotten very busy. There's a great line, I think, that sums it up in the film The Shawshank Redemption, if you've ever seen it. It's one of our favorite films. It's a wonderful film. The character in the film, Brooks Hanlon, gets released from prison after something like 60 years, so he has no idea what the world outside the prison is like, and he writes a letter back to his friends in prison, and he says the world's gone and gotten itself in a big hurry. And it often seems like we've forgotten how to pause. The patience is gone. We've forgotten how to pause and to still ourselves and to evaluate what's really important in life, to work out what the real priorities in life are. I'm sure you'll agree that it's more prevalent at times like this, you know, times of the year like this. I'm sure we've all been busy bees, as they say. We've all been running around making final preparations for the big day. We've been up early this morning and getting things sorted out. Younger folk, it's easier. It's all about making sure the letter's away to Santa, get your time busying themselves, getting the milk and the mince pies out for Santa coming, getting the carrots out for the reindeer, and then we sit impatiently waiting for the big man to come. For those of us who are slightly older, it's a busy time as well, isn't it? We've been running around for the past couple of weeks, maybe even the last couple of days, making sure we've all the presents sorted, getting the food sorted, getting the turkey, the ham, the spuds, all of that sorted and cooked out. And then, of course, sitting impatiently while the minister rambles on, hoping that it's not getting burnt while he's talking away. And we just can't wait to sit down this afternoon with a big full belly full of turkey and ham and relax. There is a busyness and a buzz around Christmas, but sometimes we really do need to just pause, to still ourselves and to focus on what is important. We need to pause to recognize the wonder and the awe at the reality of what it means to have God in our lives. It's good for us to recognize what God has actually done for us, especially at this time of the year. Sometimes we get so busy, even at times like this. We've talked already today about coming at a really special time of the year when we recognize that God sent His Son into this world. He sent His Son into this world to grow up and to sacrifice His life for our sins. But we get so busy and so cluttered up with all the trappings of the celebrations and so on, we lose sight of that. And this morning I just want to play a little video. It's only a couple of minutes long, and I hope it helps us think about the importance of pausing. Because if we just go along with the flow, if we let all the busyness of today be the focus, then we miss the most important message for us. We miss the most important message that we have for the world today. It's good for us to come here and to spend this time focusing on that message, but of course we can leave here and just go with the flow of the rest of the day. Sit back and enjoy. Hopefully the little video will play.
My mama told me something when I was growing up that has forever changed my life. She played the piano at our little church at 3rd and Pine Street for 37 years. She tried to teach me to play the piano, but I wasn't very good. She would teach me the names of the notes, what a major key is, what a minor key is. She tried to teach me musical theory, but I was just bored. Then, one day, she told me that the best news in the world is found by playing a simple scale on the piano. I had no idea what she meant, so she told me to play an 8-note scale. So I did. I said, "How is that good news?" And she said I played it incorrectly and that I needed to play it the other way. So I did. Again, I said, "How is that good news?" And she said, "I played it the right way, but I needed to add the pauses." "The pauses?" She said, "The pauses. Add them on the first, second, fourth, sixth, seventh, and last note." Now, I was frustrated and said, "How can 8 notes with random pauses be the best news in the world?" Then I got up, walked away, and went outside. Frankly, I didn't care what she was talking about. I didn't like playing the piano anyway. Well, years later, my mama got sick and passed away. As I was thinking about her, I remembered what she told me about the piano. Not only that, I still remember the notes she told me to pause. The first, second, fourth, sixth, seventh, and last note. So I sat down at her piano and played the scale with the pauses. She was talking about.
Pause makes all the difference, doesn't it? Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth receive her King. Let's all stand and let's sing it together as we close our time of worship together. Let's stand.
Thank you.
Let's just pray as we close. Father, we thank you for this time of worship once again, and we pray, Lord, that as we go about our separate ways today, as we go to celebrate with family and friends, we would indeed know something of your blessing, Lord. Remind us of your goodness to us this day. Remind us what we are celebrating. We pray now the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit would go with each of us now and forevermore. Amen. Amen.